All right, everybody good? All right, we got mics around the room. Right here.
Hey, Tyler, Tyler Greenberg from WDRB. Your first time on the field in quite a while. What was that experience like for you to not only get back to playing, but have such a good
Yeah, I mean, it's such a blessing. Really grateful for the opportunity, and that was kind of my thought process the whole time, is to go out there and have fun. Really no nerves, just you only get so many opportunities with this game, and you never know what's going to happen. I was really proud of the way we played and how the team performed.
Alexis.
You look at just the weapons around you. I mean, obviously, you know, you kind of have a fall camp, but to see that, you know, with Jaden and Ja'Cory and Chris, how nice is that just to have those kind of guys around you? And what does that do for you in terms of your confidence?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great point. I feel like complete confidence going in each snap with them. You know, whatever the defense is going to get us, I feel like I can go to any guy on any given route. You know, whether it's deep, short, they all have a special package. It's the first time in my career where I felt that comfortability. All three of them, you know, all of our wide receiver core, they do a really good job. You know, we have a lot of plays, and, you know, they study their butts off and do a great job of being friendly and going out there and making plays. So, you know, I couldn't do it without those guys getting down the field.
Tyron, on a couple of throws you made, I think the touchdown to Jaden, the 33-yarder to Jaden, and maybe even one to Redmond, who stayed in the pocket to take a hit.
Mm-hmm.
What was that like? Like, were you one of these guys who feel like you need to take a hit after, you know, your first time coming back, just to kind of feel like you're going to the
end? Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say I'm one of those guys. I really was just, you know, trying to stand in there and give him a chance. More than that was my thought process, was to give him a chance to go make a play when they're bringing pressure. I think it's always nice when you get out there and you can take a lick and get your bell rung or get hit, and kind of wakes you up a little bit. But we do a really good job of pregame getting us going. So it was really just out there kind of, you know, playing in flow state and trying to give him a chance.
Tom.
There were a couple times I think I saw you go sidearm, throw off platform. How comfortable are you doing that? And is that something you want to do frequently, just part of your game?
Yeah, I feel really comfortable doing it. I feel like it's a been a strength to my, that, you know, I've been able to add to my game the past couple of years. And there's times where, you know, on screens and other protections, and, you know, if you have to escape, or it is necessary. But my goal is always to be on platform when I can, and to have a good base. But sometimes, you know, I feel like I can and pull that out, and, you know, they do a really good job of letting me play free and you know, understanding, you know, when to use different throws and when to use different footwork, and it's really built into the offense well, and so I feel really comfortable doing it.
Anybody else for Tyler?
Yeah,
Alexis, then Eric.
I guess just when you look at the run game, I mean, you have Isaac and Keelan and Maurice. I mean, is that kind of nice too, to have that balance as well? What did you see from some of those younger guys?
Yeah, man, I mean, it was really exciting to see, just because, you know, we're in fall camp, and, you know, the whole offseason, a lot of time we're doing thuds, so they may blow the whistle down, you know, earlier than, you know, they get marked down earlier than you think, and they're out there breaking tackles, making big plays, doing a great job in protection. And so I was really proud of the whole running back room. It's like a five-headed monster. I mean, every single guy was making plays. So, you know, I think that was a big question mark for a lot of fans, you know, with two really good running backs in Isaac and Jawar leaving last year. And I think the whole staff, and myself included, feel really good about all those guys. And I know there's going to be a lot of more touchdowns to come for that whole room.
Tyler, with all the new guys on this team and playing in key roles, you might think there'd be a lot of penalties, a lot of sloppy mistakes, but there weren't any. How important was it? And what does it say that it was such a clean, especially first half, for this team?
Yeah, I mean, I think it really helps with the helmet communications and doing a good job with our signals. You know, we practice that a lot. And then, you know, we study a lot, and we put in the work, and the guys are really proud of them and playing fast. And, you know, it helps when guys have that confidence playing, and they've studied and they've done their job. So it puts me in a really easy position, you know, when they're doing that.
Did you do okay with the iPad? Did you use it much in this game? Was that something you went to at all?
Yeah. I think it was nice, you know, coming after each drive and seeing a certain couple third down looks. You know, they were trying to heat us up quite a bit and early on, and then they'll drop out and play cover two and some third down and long looks. But it was definitely helpful. Sometimes, you know, you can talk a little bit, but it was definitely a good addition.
So, yeah.
Tyler, you mentioned freedom, the word freedom. How much freedom do you have in terms of changing plays and that kind of thing within the offense?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's kind of full reign, you know, within reason. We go into we have a really good communication system as far as down a distance. You know, I'm not going to just check a play to check it, but if there's a a certain look that we like to take advantage of. If we're going to flip a run to a different side or get into a bit more advantageous run based on their front, they're giving me the full capabilities to do that. And especially in, sometimes in those passing situations, we had a couple checks where, you know, almost had a couple of big plays. And there's also a couple of areas where I could have checked this into a better play when they're bringing cover zero. So I got to be better when it comes to that. But they've done a really good job of coaching all the guys to see when we're going to get into a different play and go execute it.
Last three, Rick, Matt, Tyler.
Yeah, Tyler, after a couple of the Saturday scrimmages, Coach Brom was not real complimentary of the offense. Did anything change over the last couple of weeks? And did you share any of the concerns he had about the defense dominating you guys early on?
No, I think that's normal. I think when you go into spring and fall camp, you want your defense to be really dominant. And, you know, you're going against the same team every single day, and they're really talented. They put up a goose egg, and, you know, that goes to show for the staff and the whole guys on defense. They make it really tough on us, and I don't think it wasn't necessarily an underperformance in the fall. It was really, you know, we were doing our job, and I think, you know, as an offensive-minded coach, whenever there's a little bit of mistakes, and, you know, including myself, you know, you get a little bit of a sour taste when there's a couple plays you wish you had back. So I think maybe that's where it's coming from, but, I mean, short answer is the defense is really good, so they make it hard on us. I'm glad, you know, they get to play somebody else now.
Tyler, what was it like using the in-helmet communication for the first time in a live game?
It was great. You know, there was a couple times where Coach forgot to press it. I think he was getting it on a roll, so we had to slow it down a little bit. And there's a couple times where maybe got a little fuzzy, but for the most part, you know, Ed and the equipment guys and all the whole staff did a really good job of handling that, and definitely streamlined a lot of that.
Last one, Tyler.
Yeah, Tyler, this was your first real game working with Jeff and Brian in live action. Is there something you've noticed about them and how they work with you in this type of scenario that you can't really learn until you get out?
Yeah, no, I think they have a really good dynamic as far as just playing off of each other, understanding when to come talk to me, understanding when to let it roll. Was communicating with Brian on the headset, sometimes on the sideline, and then Coach Jeff does a great job of talking me through the headset, you know, whenever we had that time, and also on the field, you know, we're kind of on the same page as what we're trying to get done. So it was a lot of fun getting to work with them, and I know every week's going to get tougher, and we got to be ready to roll. So it's going to be a new challenge coming into practice tomorrow and the next week to continue that.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.